rhythm to creative bits.
Hey everybody, Christian Gabriel here, and welcome to another tutorial. Today we're going to talk about creating a project in the brand new 2022 Premiere. A few weeks ago, Adobe gave us a new Premiere update. We are currently on version 22.4. If you're on any version before 22.3 or 22.4, you might be really surprised when you go to create a brand new project. Check this out. I'm going to say new project, and there you go. All of a sudden, we have something entirely different, a brand new way, a simpler way of creating a project. I like it. Some people, they're a little freaked out about it. So let's check this out. Let's go ahead and go through the basics of creating a typical Premiere project. So you just need to know that there's a difference between your media and your project. So basically, your project and media are separate. They can be put in the same folder, they could be separated in different folders on the same drive, or they could be separate on multiple drives. However you set up your project, you just want to be very, very organized. Let's talk about setting up a project. Before you even open up Premiere, one of the good things to do is create a single folder on a hard drive, wherever your project is going to be. If it's a smaller project, you could do something like right-click, and let's go ahead and create a brand new folder here, and maybe call it, it could be 2022, creating a project, something very simple. One of the easy ways to set up a project to make sure nothing is disconnected or you have no problems with your media when you open the project is to just create a simple master folder or some sort of primary folder that you can keep your project and media in. Now, this would only work if you have smaller amounts of media, like you're doing a commercial or a music video or something like that. If you're doing a feature film, you're probably dedicating that media across a single drive or even multiple drives.
I'm Spartacus.
On a professional level, you'd be working across servers and server partitions. There are many different ways to work with Premiere to set that up as well. But let's say we're just setting up a very simple project here. I'm going to start by creating a folder called 2022 Creating a Project right here. That'll be my master folder. Inside of there, I'm going to create another folder called Footage. Okay, there we go. And I'm just keeping things very simple. You could really name these folders anything you want. It's really what is easiest for you when you're navigating your own media. I'm just going to generically name this footage. I'm going to right click, create another folder called Premiere Projects. Very good. And I would do that for any small project just to keep everything together. So now that we have that, if I go ahead and let me just make this a little bit bigger, we have a folder that will have our Premiere project in it, and then we'll have a folder with our footage in it, which means that when we're in our Premiere project, we can import footage from this folder. Everything stays connected because both of these folders are in the same folder. Now, the reason, at the very least, to put a project in a folder is that your project, as you start editing, will create many different types of files and folders that could be scattered across your desktop or wherever you decide to save it. So by putting your project in a folder, you're really keeping things organized. If that was all you did, that would be a win. So there you go. I just put my footage in my folder here. And if I go ahead, double click here, I just have a bunch of just random clips going on in here, stock clips. And then I have my Premiere project folder, which I'm about to save a project inside of. Now I'm ready to start Premiere. So I'm gonna bring up Premiere. All right. So whether you create a new project or whether it opens up this way, you will be greeted by this window. This is the brand new project creation window. And there's so many things we can do in here. It's actually a simplified window. Now, those of you that are used to the old window, don't worry, that is all there. Once you're inside of your project, you could actually go to your project settings window and still tweak all of those old settings. The two things that you cannot ignore are up in the top left, okay? So that is project name and project location. So that should be very simple because we just created folders for those. So if I created a project name here, maybe I could just call this maybe Coca-Cola project, which this has nothing to do with Coca-Cola, but that's okay. Hopefully I don't get sued. There you go. So Coca-Cola project V1, and then I could go ahead and drop this down and go to choose location. And then I could just locate this to my Premiere Projects folder. Now that I'm in my Premiere Projects folder right here, I'm just gonna go ahead and either select my Premiere Projects folder or double click inside of it. Either way, you're just saying, this is where you'd like to save your project. I'm going to say select folder. Great. Now that I've set that up, if that's all I did, it's a win, because if I hit create in the bottom right, that's now going to create a brand new project. Of course, it will be an empty project with no media, but that's okay. It will create a brand new project. Adobe has broken down the editing process and applied that to navigation in Premiere. Right in the upper left-hand corner, you'll see that we have three tabs. These are brand new as of 2022. They're called Import, Edit, and Export. So they're really meant to break down the offline, online editing process. So of course, you create your project and then you import media into your project, you edit your media, and then you go ahead and export your media. So these different tabs will allow you to click between those stages, and that really makes things very clear and straightforward and very easy. I really love this interface here. This is how everything else breaks down. On the left-hand side, you just have some quick ways to navigate throughout your system to find the clips that you would like. In the middle here are going to be clips, and right now they're being populated by simple stock clips that Adobe has put in there, so you're just not looking at emptiness, basically. So these are Adobe sample clips here. And of course, I could click on any of these clips or all of these clips if I'd like to actually select them for import. I could make them bigger, I could make them smaller. I could see them in this little grid-like fashion, grid view, or I could view them as a list. I could make the clips bigger, I could make them smaller. Once again, very nice. I could even filter out based on camera, supported cameras and elements like that as well. There's some really nice features up here. I could filter out video versus audio. I could filter out red camera versus RE camera. Things you can do in here. It's very nice. So first off, if you select a clip or many clips, you'll see if they will be highlighted in this kind of pale blue right here. And you'll see what's about to be linked in your project, because you'll see clips appear at the bottom. If this was a folder that you selected, then you'd see folders accompanied by a number. And that number represents the number of clips inside of that folder. And so now, of course, if you select a folder for import, it's actually gonna select its contents for import, and you'll need to create a folder before your clips come in. So let's say I just wanted to bring these clips right here, and I just selected these five clips. Now what I can do is go to the right-hand side and tell Premiere that I would like to put it in a new bin. So going from top to bottom, I can copy media, I can create a new bin, and I could create a new sequence. Copy media is very cool. It means that if you select any clips or folders full of clips, you'll be able to copy that media using MD5 verification. MD5 verification is an algorithm that can do a lot of things, but it's frequently used as a checksum to verify data integrity. It is something that can verify that what you copy has copied successfully. You can also copy without verification. If you don't have the copy button on, it means that any clips that you're using, you're keeping them in their original location. Whereas this copy media will actually copy them to a new location, perhaps a new location within that folder. Since our clips are already located where we want them, we would turn this option off. Once again, new bin will actually create a brand new bin, and this is the bin that all your clips will go in. So once again, if I turn that on and call that bin footage, then when the project is created, you will see there is a folder called footage with all of your clips inside. Create new sequence will create a new sequence based off of the first clip that you selected for import. So if that first clip is 1920 by 1080 at 30 frames per second, then that's what your sequence will be. If the first clip you selected is 3840 by 2160, that new sequence will be 4K UHD. So I'm only turning on the new bin feature here. I've already named my project. I told it where my project is going to go. Everything feels pretty great here. So now I'm just gonna say create. So here's my brand new project with my footage folder and of course my clips inside, all ready to go. So if you notice my interface is different from yours, no worries. This is just a custom interface that I've created. If you're booting up Premiere for the first time, you'll be in one of the default interfaces. Now, for those of you that have been using Premiere, you'll notice that at the beginning, there are a few features missing from creating a new project. So those features are still located under File and then Project Settings. If I go to Project Settings and then General, this will pop back up. And here we can retweak anything we want, including a render if you have multiple video cards or you would like to switch off of your video card or dependence on that video card. If you would like to tweak any of the color management features or anything else, everything is here. All right, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed that little jaunt through how to create an Adobe project. If you felt like this was too short, don't worry. I'm gonna be covering a whole lot more very soon. So if you would like to be notified of that, just go ahead and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.